Hi, Keara. Congratulations. You've been selected as a potential grand prize winner in Adobe's Great Untold contest. You have won $10,000, a digital code for 1 year subscription of Adobe Creative Cloud.
Yeah! Let's go!
Yeah!
This is The Great Untold. Based on the belief that great stories can come from anywhere, Netflix and Adobe came together and hit the road in search of storytellers in unexpected places around the country. Each winner was paired with a mentor and given the tools to help turn their submission video into a fully produced short film. These are the stories only they could tell.
Action. Winning this competition was a really big surprise. We don't generally get these kind of like opportunities in Alaska. So it felt really good knowing that somebody wanted to know about how people live in Alaska. My name is Keara Anderson and I am 21 years old. I was born and raised in Healy, Alaska. It's a very small town. I think there's about 1,000 people that live here year round. The coal mine really is one of the biggest things that keeps the community together. We are very close to Denali National Park, so there's a lot of wilderness all around you. When we got our first grocery store, it was a really big deal because before we only had 2 gas stations. You'd have to plan your groceries for like a month out.
Gotta feed the crew.
All right.
You have to be very self-sufficient. The winters, they can get very cold. Being resourceful, it takes a lot of planning.
These are all the berries that we picked.
Which I think has really helped also on this film, because, you know, you have to think ahead for filming. After I graduated in 2019, I decided that I really wanted to pursue a career in film. Coming to the decision to leave was a struggle. I told myself that you need to leave Alaska because there's not the kind of film opportunities you want. Going through that process, I just tried not to think about it a whole lot and just was like, this is what I need to do, so this is what you're going to do.
Hi. I just wanted to call to, talk to you about maybe leaving Alaska.
The story that I'm looking to tell is a story about a character named Jesse. And they are faced with the decision of leaving Alaska, like some of their friends, or staying in their hometown.
Last of the Wild is definitely based on that debate on like staying or leaving and how that feels.
I am now going to be starting a crazy process. I have to put all these pieces together in 2 weeks, and I'm pretty terrified because there's so much that's going to be happening, but just as excited. It's just such an incredible opportunity that I was not expecting in a million years.
The past day has been kind of a little stressful because I thought the script was where I wanted it, but then my mentor had some really good notes about, you know, what the audience is gonna think and what they're gonna get from each of the scenes.
Hey, Keara.
Hi.
How fun, how's it going?
It's going well, how are you?
I'm so good.
My mentor for this project is Maisie. She has definitely pushed me to get a really like strong script.
I was really curious as to, with your protagonist, Jesse, right?
Mm-hmm.
Jesse, yeah. So like what is at stake for him if he goes or if he stays?
Yeah, definitely I need to have like a really strong, you know, like conflict and like what Jesse wants.
My name is Maisie Richardson-Sellers and I'm an actress, a director and a screenwriter. When I first read Keara's first draft of her script, I could tell that she was nervous about script writing. I could tell that she didn't think that that was her strength.
Starting the writing process, I didn't know exactly how to say what I wanted to do. I knew the
the basics of it, but I just didn't know how to express that on paper.
So that's one of the things that we worked on together quite a lot, was just how do you bring a story to life?
How do we make the audience feel emotionally connected to the landscape in the same way that Jesse is? I'm trying to think of something which we can sort of show twice, like you kind of have, but that is really about his relationship with the land.
With the land, yeah.
I think we're on version probably 16 of the script now. Some days it's been, you know, kind of frustrating trying to get like all the details to work out, but I think it's going to be really helpful to have her and her experience on set.
Thanks so much, Keara. Okay, I'll speak to you soon. I'll see you on Wednesday.
See you then.
Today we start location scouting.
Well, I was actually thinking of running up to the mine for a second there.
Okay.
We can go up the back way if we wanted to, and just see if there's anything that's appealing there.
Yeah. My dad has helped me out a lot on this film. He's taken time off work. He's very excited about this whole filming process.
The pit was right there, but this doesn't look like we're gonna hit it here.
Shoots. We currently are trying to find this one like reclamation site. And we've tried three entrances, and my dad trying to figure it out.
My dad has also let us use his ATVs, his four-wheeler, his six-wheeler. He's a great builder.
Actually, this case built special for this, because Jesse's going to have his like planters with like the trees, and then we're gonna have like a gun carry case. There's not gonna be a real gun in there.
Honestly, he could be like labeled like production designer at this moment. He's taking care of so many of these details.
The reason that we are mudding is for the film. And we are needing to get the truck muddy. Oh my God, we can't see.
Oh, my new windshield wiper's not good.
Whoa. So this is the crew's RV.
My dad was able to borrow the trailer that houses some of my crew. So this is where somebody's gonna be sleeping. And then in here, we have three people kind of in a little cot situation. The land that my parents own that we will be filming on is around 7 to 10 acres. We're gonna be just filming on a portion of it.
Wait, we're going to the path for day three, right?
Yeah.
This is the House Woods?
Yes. This is the okay. House Woods, yeah.
Copy. Okay.
And we might do this like as a splinter and do this in the morning of the bonfire.
Pretty much everyone on my crew, everyone's like from Alaska. But our first AD, Enrique, is from New Mexico.
I've kind of been plugged into this local Alaskan crew, kind of showing me around, pointing random plants at me, telling me don't touch that because it'll kill me.
This is called Death Camas. A lot of people think it's really pretty. We've had kids come over and want to pick it, and it's like, no, this is actually like...
They die.
It could cause death, so, yeah.
Push that, push down on your shift lever right now, and you're gonna see it go to reverse.
Dad, we're gonna follow you. Okay. First up, we're gonna be doing this precision driving to see if it's doable and safe. If not, we need to figure out a different alternative.
We're gonna go faster and then you can like get into the road.
My sister, Kezia, will be shooting the film. We both are interested in filmmaking. We work a lot together. She's my best friend.
Nice, that's good.
That's great, nice.
I think that went well.
Yeah, I think that went well too.
We're gonna try like stabilizing it in post, and then we're gonna try it with
the gimbal. Once we get access.
We'll see how that goes. It might be easier just do it handheld on.
Yeah. As a kid, my sister and I would make some like iPhone films or like with our point and shoot camera. We definitely did a lot of like funny photo shoots. I would not be here without my sister, for sure. I mean, even she sent me the competition link, and she was like the one that was like, we need to do this.
We have a wide, that's in the berry patch. Flatlands is scene one, you're right. We've basically just been running through all the shots, been like going through the shot list and everything. I'm editing it too, so I feel like Keara and I have a pretty good idea of like how we want everything to go.
I think what we're gonna have is like the drone be more up in that, like if this was a square, more over in that corner, pointing towards us.
So you want it from over there then? You want like the drone to be facing that way or facing that way?
It's gonna be facing, so it's gonna be facing this way.
Does that break the?
Does it break the 180?
I thought it needed to be more facing that way where I'm facing.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's just get it
let's
up
try
in there
that.
And then see how it.
My sister and I generally agree on a lot of things, but sometimes when it comes to like framing and filming, we'll see things differently or the way we communicate them. I think that's where our disagreements come from. But it's a fun and like special experience to like be able to work on this project together. Hi, Maisie.
Finally, oh my gosh.
Oh, so good.
Look at you in the real life.
Yeah,
it's
I
so
know.
Exciting. And this is your set.
This is my set. This wow. is for the bonfire.
It's so stunning. I grew up in London. I had a bit of experience in the British countryside, but nothing prepared me for Alaska.
There's such a kind of haunting beauty here, mm-hmm. and it feels so alive. You really feel the presence of nature all around
yeah.
you and the power of that and that sense of interconnected, you know,
yeah.
in our relationship with nature.
I agree. How does it feel being back here?
It feels really good being back home. Definitely being back on the ground. It's like easier to kind of like see the vision.
You have a massive strong suit of being very organized, and that's going to be a huge superpower for you in your directing career. I think one of the biggest lessons that I had to learn, because I'm quite similar to you in that way, is also that it's okay to be vulnerable. You know, it's okay to not know what's going on and to ask for help from the team around you and to lean on the team. And sometimes by doing that, you will find moments and find experiences that you would never have even thought of.
Yeah.
So make sure that you can still be flexible. Mm-hmm. Make sure you're still responsive to the environment. And if something's not working, let it go.
Mm-hmm.
Find another way to tell that story.
If I have everything kind of laid out, then I really hope that we have more time to play
yeah.
on the day.
If there was one thing that you would love for an audience member to leave after mm-hmm. having watched your film, like what is that one feeling or that sentiment?
I think realizing that, you know, Alaska is a beautiful place, but, you know, without the people, it's not quite the same. Like, it will still always be beautiful, but, you know, it takes like a relationships and like people scattered throughout the land to like define it.
It's really exciting.
I'm excited. And a little scared. Don't worry, there's still a tint of fear, don't worry.
It'll come, don't
yeah.
worry. Even if you're not feeling it now,
there.
It's gonna come.
Yeah.
It's kind of coming up into fall now.
Yeah.
Are you concerned or any questions or anything about the weather?
Yeah, weather is definitely a concern.
The main issue we're troubleshooting right now is trying to find batteries that we can plug into.
What? So we got this equipment from LA and we're missing some pieces. Is this her monitor? Okay, got it.
Yeah, just the issue is we can't use them both at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'd be like 2 hours away to like the nearest rental place. We have to figure it out tonight because tomorrow we're just like filming the whole day, so. We don't have too much time to figure it out then.
So the main issue is that we can't connect to power.
Right.
Because these batteries don't have that.
Got it. They didn't give us the right mm-hmm. cord.
What's mm-hmm. the cheapest?
Yeah, that's a little disappointing, but.
And that's one crisis. So the other
one,
crisis.
Okay, got it.
As of right now, we can't get the folks supposed to work.
Do you think we could like get in contact with like the LA rental house just to see like what their thought process was with it? Yeah, it's just hard because like we just got it all and now it's like the weekend, so it's like there's not much we can do, you know.
We don't have a way of plugging this in, so what I'm trying to do is set up my Milwaukee batteries to power these up.
Do you think we can use these batteries?
We can, but what I would really like to do is run my M18 batteries. They're like 18 to 20 volts coming off.
Okay,
hell yeah. Let's pause on that crisis. Let's see.
Bye. All right, crisis over.
Thank God.
rolling. Quite low round, please.
Last of the Wild, scene 1F, take 1.
And action. Cut.
let him clock the view.
Yeah.
And then that's when it's like, oh, this is beautiful.
On day one, we ended up on what was called the flatland in the script, which was not flat in any sense. It was this fantastic mountainous ex-coal mine, but that's now been sort of reclaimed. And I think it's a beautiful setting for this film.
This shot, you're gonna be on your knees and you're patting the dirt around the tree.
Keara and I met at the University of Alaska Fairbanks studying film. We've been together for like 2 years. Honestly, having her direct me in a film, it's cool to like kind of know our dynamics already, especially with all the other crew too. Like, we all grew up like together basically studying film, so it's cool to be able to like put them to use and stuff.
All right, cut.
So that's it with the bay patch?
That's it with the bay patch.
Heading back up?
Yep, we're heading back up.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm getting lunch.
That's me.
That's you. This is you.
Thank you.
Okay. For this film, my mom has helped me out a lot by providing and getting like all of the food to feed my crew.
Okay, so we have hot water if you want tea, cider, cocoa.
Feed everyone like 3 meals a day, also have snacks. So she's kind of acting kind of as like the den mother essentially and like taking care of everyone. A lot of people won't see her doing all this, but she's been like baking for like 3 weeks in advance. She's been like really helpful. Oh my God. There's a moose. Oh, there's a moose.
It blended really well. Last of the Wild, scene 21, Charlie, take 6.
Did you see the lightning?
Looks like there's two storms there, what I seen on the phone. I don't know, might not even come this way. Might pass over.
Okay, so right now we're about one scene away from ending our day, and there's a massive storm coming, so, fingers crossed, we're pushing, we're almost there. Hopefully we'll make it.
Hey, bro. Yeah, no, I'm doing fine. Yeah, my wheeler's out of gas, though.
And cut.
That's a cut. All right, y'all, it's raining, let's get out of here. Let's get the equipment wet. All right, let's go.
We still have another scene to shoot. Hopefully this will clear up.
Rolling. Quiet all around, please.
Sound? Alaska weather can be very unpredictable. I've been telling all my cast and crew, bring thermals, bring layers. Keeps you on the edge, keeps you on your toes.
Fantastic first day.
Thank you. I definitely think like the timing of the beats and like the way they interact needs some work either in the edit.
I mean, I think, you know, you've got some really great stuff. It's amazing that you already have this, like the opening, basically.
Yeah.
Do you have the last scene?
Yes. The beat at the wheeler, like after he kind of like loses it, that needs to be like a quicker realization.
I feel like we need to see his eyes more. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to tell the actor, like, we need to see your eyes. Like, you have to, like, that's part of the job. It's like, they have to find a way to make it work for camera.
Yeah.
It might not feel right to them always in the moment, but if we can't see them, we can't engage with them.
Yeah. Action. Camera might need you guys to cheat it a little bit, depending on, like, the blocking and stuff. All right, guys, we got some finicky camera stuff. I'm not sure how quick this problem is gonna be fixed, but try to stay dry somehow.
Yeah, the focus pulling's just been very rough today for some reason. I don't know, but I think we got the shot.
All right, guys, we'll go over gun safety. We act like a gun is always loaded.
Going through this experience of making my film, it has really shown me how grateful I am for the resourcefulness and self-sufficiency that I had to learn growing up in this remote wilderness. Parts and pieces throughout this whole process have changed. And so really knowing like what I want at the end of the day from the film, being able to really stick with a vision,
I think that that is a strength that I kind of gained going through this.
All right, y'all, that's a picture wrap.
Thank you all for your hard work on this film. It's meant so much to me that you all can be a part of this and be here to make this with me.
And I'm so excited for you all to see the film.
And again, thank you for all your hard work. All right.
I think this view looks really pretty from here.
Also, this is like, I don't know why it feels so slow there.
Yeah, we can definitely tighten this up though. Mm-hmm.
Kezia and I started the editing process at the beginning of the shoot. Every night we would try to do some like dailies or just like scene assemblies to see if we got everything we needed.
So how's it looking?
I'm interested to see how it all cuts together for sure.
We only have 5 minutes, so it's either like we have to cut out a piece of the script or we just have to go with shots that we don't like. Because there's a lot that happens in the script and it's not really a lot of time. But yeah, this is my editing buddy. He's here for moral support.
Kezia would just edit pretty much all throughout the day. We did edit mostly in the kitchen.
I'm excited for you to see this cut. I have it all colored in here. Look at that. Does that look like something a maniac would do?
It's pretty nice.
The first cut is always probably the one everyone hates the most. There was a lot of things that I was excited about, and there was a lot of things that it was like, okay, wow, that's how it is reading right now. And so we have to change some of these pieces.
This whole part, I want to cut out. I think you should be like, hey, Bent, I'm out of gas, you know?
Yeah, I don't think we need to see the whole gas thing and everything.
It was definitely Kezia and I trying to focus on, like, what is the goal of the film? Like, is it still getting across the same message?
That scene, I just took out the wide completely because I don't think it's giving us much. And he's definitely not going as fast as you and I thought that he would.
It was not scripted that Jesse would scream at the end of the film, but that was something that the actor improvised and we liked it. So that was one thing that was not planned for in the script. That was something we discovered on the day, and that's something that did make it into the cut. We went back and got pickup shots to use the scream at the end.
Today is our reshoot, day 2. These are pickup shots we found out we needed after doing the edit. So yeah, we have to get that. Kezia is actually going to be our photo double Jesse. So yeah, I'm going to be camera opping today and I will also be flying the drone.
I'm just really excited to share this with people and to be able to be like, see, this is something that I made with my team. Being able to tell a story that pertains to like Alaska and being an Alaskan filmmaker is really such a good feeling.
Beneath me, the spruce-scented wind in my face, and over 500,000 miles of freedom. This is why I'll never leave this land. Hey, bro.
Hey, what's up? You good?
Yeah, no, I'm doing fine. My wheeler's out of gas, though.
Again? Dude, you gotta remember to bring your gas. I'm on the way. Where'd you be without me?
It's gonna be our last ride for a while.
Come on now, don't get sad on me.
Go. This last day in Alaska is just the sun, the rain, the wind.
Yeah.
Hey! It's a Ben!
Leaving and losing his Alaskan identity.
It's a Ben!
Like, is he like just graduated?
Cheers to not Alaska.
To not Alaska.
Exactly.
Absolutely, yes.
Who are you going to hang out with after all of this leave?
Cheers. To not Alaska.
To not Alaska.
You're really going to let your little brother go to the lower 48 alone?
You know what? Actually, I think that's dirty. Hold on.
Yeah, well, whenever it's Seb's stuff, it's always.
You don't call your brother no more, or what?
I'm sorry, dude. I've had a lot going on.
How's your new city life going?
But, yeah, sorry. I haven't had the chance to call you.
So, things are going well then?
Yeah, it's been crazy fun. But what have you been up to since we left?
Staying busy, just holding the fort down.
What do you mean holding the fort down? For who?
I mean, for when you and the boys come back.
Dude, we went over this.
You're not missing it at all? All the times together and stuff?
That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying, like, I don't miss that place. I'm kind of hoping you'll come down here.
Yeah, well, I've been busy here too. Exploring and planting more trees, and I nearly have that whole plot done, actually.
Dude, it's just a job. Like, you could have any tree planting job wherever you want.
It's not just a job, it's this place. I love it.
Do it all the time. It never misses.
I think you're going to miss out on a lot. Up there, all alone? Are you trying to say I miss you? I'm coming. I should probably go. You know you can love Alaska and leave it too.
Yeah, okay. I'll let you go. Thank you.